Hello everyone, I welcome you all to my channel. Today I will be showing you how to install PyCharm IDE in your Windows operating system. PyCharm is one of the most popular IDE among the Python community, and also it is a very important IDE if you want to do any Python related project. So let's dive in how to install PyCharm IDE in your Windows operating system. So for that, I will be opening my Chrome browser and type PyCharm IDE download for Windows 64-bit. Now here, the first search result is from this JetBrains.com. So they are basically the developer of this beautiful Python IDE. So just click on that. And now just close this cookies. Now here, basically there are two options. One is a professional one and another is a community one. Now this professional one is a paid one. You can use it for a few days if you want to use for, as a free trial. Otherwise you need to buy it, or you can download this community one. So for that, to download the community one, just click on the download. It's free and open source, and as soon as you click that, your downloading will start. And see, this community version is now currently downloading. Now I have already downloaded this PyCharm community, so I will just cancel this and I will just go to my download section and I will just install from my downloaded version. So just double click on the product, and now here the PyCharm installer is now showing you welcome to PyCharm community edition setup. So you just need to click on next. And this is the location where the installation is going to happen. If you want to change your location, then you can just click on the browse and you can just change your destination. If you don't have any solid reason to change your destination, then just simply click next. Now here you will get some options. Now the first option is telling that whether if you want to create a desktop shortcut. So for that, I want PyCharm to create a desktop shortcut. So for that, I'll just check that out. And then if you want to add open folder as a project, so I just want that. And the third option is the create associations. So for that, I will not check this, because if I check this, then all my other Python programs will be opened by this PyCharm, which I don't want, because there are some other machine learning files also which I want to open in Anaconda. So for that reason, I don't want all my other Python files to open in PyCharm. So I will not just tick that, and so I'll just check these two options and I'll just simply click next. Now as soon as you click next, you will be showing this option, that is this choose start menu folder. So I'll just simply keep all this default and I'll just click on install. Now as soon as you click on install, your installation process will get start. You can click on show details to check all those installation processes currently going on. So I'll just speed this up and I'll come back when it gets done. Now as you can see, my installation has been finished. So I will just click this check option, that is to run my PyCharm community edition, and I will just simply click on finish. Now here PyCharm has been launched, so I need to just click on some terms and conditions. So let's confirm that and click on continue. Now the JetBrains is asking if you want to share your user statistics to them. So for which I would not like to send my user statistics. So for that, I'll just simply click on don't send. If you want to send, then you can just click on send anonymous statistics. I will not like to send my user statistics, so I just simply click on don't send. And now here my PyCharm has been launched. Now just maximize that and click on create new project. So just type a name of our project. So for that, I'll just typing our first PyCharm project. Okay, so I will just keep all other things as default, and as you can see, we are using Python 3.8. So just simply click on create and your project will be then created. Now as you can see, you need to have an active internet connection right throughout this installation process. As you can see that the IDE is now currently downloading Python 3.8.6 version on your system. So it will take some time and it will ask you for some administration privileges. So just give that and just wait for a few minutes and it will get installed. So I'll just speed this up and I'll come back once it's done. So now as you can see, all other packages that were downloading are now downloaded. Now this PyCharm installation has been finished. So I'll just maximize this and I will just simply click on the run button to run the default program that they have given us. So here is, as you can see, like the output has came high PyCharm. So I just simply change this to hi everyone and I will just run this, and as you can see the output has been came like hi everyone. Now if you want to create a new project, then you can simply click on file, then create a new project, and you just simply type your new project. Suppose I want to type hello world, then just click on create. Now there are basically two options if you want to create this the same project in this window or you want to create another window. So for which I would like to create another new window, so just click on that and you will get another PyCharm window will be opened. So as you can see over here, there are basically two windows. One is our first PyCharm project that I have created, and then another project that I created now, that is this hello world. So here it will take some time to create a virtual environment, so just wait for a minute or two and then it will get started. So here you can just simply click on Ctrl A and delete, and you can write your own program. It's print hello world, just say Ctrl S and then click on the run button, and as you can see the output has been came hello world. So this is how you install PyCharm in your Windows 10 operating system. So that's all for this video. If you like this video, then please give it a thumbs up and also share it with your friends, and also don't forget to subscribe our channel. Once again, thank you very much for watching this video and God bless you all.